Mungkin Ibu Hesti mau nyampaikan, silakan.
Oh ya, mungkin Ibu Hesti, monggo Bu.
Bentar. Stadium general itu
ya baterainya tinggal seberapa juga ya Dun? Ketok kan baterainya?
Ya, itu merupakan kuliah umum ya. Kuliah umum yang diberikan pakar yang ahli di bidangnya masing-masing. Jadi bisa kita dari berbagai bidang, baik dari dalam maupun luar negeri. Pun kalau dari dalam juga, dari maksudnya intern sekolah kalau memang pakar di bidangnya, misalnya dari direktorat itu untuk menyampaikan. Saya kira begitu, bisa untuk mengadakan stadium general.
Oke, ya, tepat sekali, beri tepuk tangan dulu buat Ibu Hesti untuk jawabannya. Benar sekali Ibu, jadi sebenarnya tidak ada definisi yang secara resmi terkait stadium general ini, tapi dia itu dulu sering digunakan di abad ke-13 di lingkungan universitas untuk mendeskripsikan suatu tempat di mana mahasiswa dari berbagai wilayah dapat datang untuk mendapatkan kuliah dari para ahli. Nah, kalau untuk hari ini biasanya stadium general ini dipakai di komunitas di universitas di Eropa untuk menjelaskan tentang suatu kuliah umum yang biasa kita sebut kuliah umum di Indonesia ya, yang nanti akan dihadiri mahasiswa dari berbagai tempat, dari berbagai bidang untuk mendengarkan penjelasan atau kuliah dari ahlinya. Oke, nah. Lalu kenapa sih kok kita butuh stadium general ini? Kenapa dia harus dilaksanakan di sekolah kita? Jadi, stadium general ini dibutuhkan. Nah, ini ada kaitannya dengan yang tadi yang sudah dijelaskan sama Pak Panji dan Bu Erni di presentasi sebelumnya. Jadi, stadium general ini nantinya akan memperkuat pengetahuan kalian yang mana diharapkan ke depannya kalian dapat menguasai 9 survival skills of 21st century. Ada curiosity and imagination, inquiries, critical thinking, communicative, accessing and analyzing information, agility and adaptability, collaboration and leading by influence, complex problem solving. Nah, satu lagi ada creative and productive. Nah, kesembilan survival skill ini nanti akan disajikan dalam bentuk stadium general yang akan disampaikan oleh pakarnya. Dengan cara, nah nanti kita akan mendatangkan pakar atau ahli di bidangnya untuk memberikan kuliah umum kepada siswa-siswa SMA Pradita Dirgantara dengan 7 topik yang sudah memuat 9 survival skill tadi. Yang pertama ada kepemimpinan dan kejuangan, kemudian ada critical thinking dan problem solving, ada effective oral dan written communication, inquiry, curiosity and imagination, agility and adaptability, accessing and analyzing information, tutorial of critical essay and PBS atau project based service, dan cross cultural understanding. Nah, ketujuh stadium general ini nanti akan kita laksanakan. Kemudian kapan ini? Kita akan melaksanakannya mulai tahun pelajaran ini setiap bulan di minggu kedua. Kemudian kenapa di sini cuma ada 4? Karena sebenarnya di PDWOW kita sudah melaksanakan 3 dari 7 yang saya jelaskan tadi. Jadi kepemimpinan dan kejuangan kemarin sudah kita laksanakan bersama dengan narasumber Pak Wakasau. Kemudian ada tutorial PBS dan Critical Insight, tadi baru saja disampaikan oleh Bu Erni dan Pak Panji, dan nanti akan dijelaskan lebih lanjut oleh tim global kompetensi yang lainnya, ada Pak Opik dan Pak Doni. Kemudian nanti ada juga cross-cultural understanding yang akan disampaikan oleh Pak Joko. Nah, jadi kita masih ada 4 ini nanti akan kita laksanakan setiap bulannya di minggu kedua. Kemudian, di mana akan dilaksanakan? Nah, di sini ada online dan offline. Kenapa online dan offline? Kita tahu sendiri saat ini dunia, bangsa kita khususnya sedang menghadapi wabah COVID-19 ya. Jadi, kalau misalnya memang belum memungkinkan untuk kita melaksanakan secara offline, maka akan dilaksanakan dalam bentuk online atau biasa kita kenal dengan webinar, dengan mendatangkan ahli tentunya. Oke. Mungkin itu saja tentang Stadium General, karena memang kita sudah sering ya melaksanakannya beberapa kali di sekolah, jadi mungkin anak-anak juga sudah akrab sekali dengan Stadium General. Mungkin ada yang mau bertanya, silakan. Oke, kalau tidak ada, nanti akan dilanjutkan ke materi selanjutnya, yaitu terkait cross-cultural understanding ya. Oke, silakan kepada Pak Joko bisa menuju ke, oh sorry, bukan cross-cultural understanding, tapi tentang program bahasa Inggris ya Pak Oscar. Oke, silakan Pak Oscar. Nah, Pak Oscar ini guru baru, mungkin buat anak-anak kelas 11 dan 12, juga kelas 10 yang belum familiar dengan Pak Oscar, bisa berkenalan dengan Pak Oscar.
Yeah. Thank you, Bu Widya, for the time given to me. It is a great opportunity. I'd like to continue our presentations today. This is still about global competences. Like what Bu Widya said, that I would like to talk about a language course, or specifically, I would like to say an English course, yeah, an English course for all students in Pradita Dirgantara. Okay, I would like to divide the two courses of students in Pradita Dirgantara. It will be divided into two programs. The first program is for 10 and 11th grade students. The program will be different from the English program for the 12th grade students. Okay. One thing that you have to know and aware is about, because you know these institutions, you know the visions of these institutions would like to be high school with international reputations. It means that English is a must. I mean, mastering English is a must in these institutions. So for the students, I'd like to show you this English course program. As I mentioned before, it will be divided into two programs for the 10 and 11th grade students and then 12th grade students. So what's the different program? Competence. And SMA Pradita Dirgantara will be incorporated with one of the best language center in Indonesia. Will be in corporations with Sanata Dharma lecturers. For 10 and 11th grade students, you will get the material not only from KADE set by national curriculum, but you will be enriched with materials from Sanata Dharma University. So this is for 10 and 11th grade students English program. However, for the 12th grade students, this is a continuation of the program that you have done before. You'll get materials about IELTS. You know, if you want to continue your study abroad, or maybe you would like to start your career abroad, it means that you need to have the certificates of IELTS, TOEFL, and so on. But, you know, in Pradita Dirgantara, you'll get an English training, yeah, and focus on IELTS program. And you know, in this program is not only the program, but we require the students to achieve maybe a 6.5 band score overall. I think it is high target, but I'm sure that Pradita Dirgantara students will achieve that program if you follow all the course intensively. So that's all about the English program. Yeah, I'd like to highlight that there will be two kinds of this program for the 10 and 11th grade students, and then for 12th grade students. I hope that this program will help you to improve your English in terms of communications and your English proficiency. And of course, yeah, to improve your score in English subjects, both obligatory or supplementary. So I think that's all my explanations about the English program for Pradita Dirgantara students. Maybe the questions will be, the time for question and answer will be given after Pak Joko deliver his materials about cross-cultural understanding. That's all, thank you. And I'd like to invite Pak Joko to explain about cross-cultural understanding. Thank you.
Thank you, Pak Oscar. Good morning, everyone. Oh, wait. Okay, on behalf the team of the Global Competences, I would like to explain about what is the cross-cultural understanding program at the SMA Pradita Dirgantara. What is the cross-cultural understanding, or CCU? Before going to explain about detail about this, what is the cross-cultural understanding? I have a simple question for you guys. What is the culture? For the operator, please show the chat column on the main screen, and then. For all the students at home, please answer the question, what does belong to culture? You can click the letter A, B, C, D, E, or F. Okay, so I give you 1 minute to answer the question. What does belong to culture? Okay, E, E, A to F, way of life, E, all, and then A to F, E, all of them, E, B, all, A, E, all, E, what is Yanbu? B, all. Okay, A, B, T. Zenbu means all. Okay, all, A, B, C, D, F, good. A to Z, there is the Z. L, all. Okay, wait, because we hear the azan, so we are quite a little bit. Are you done to answer the question for all the students? I think should be everything or every, oh, it mean everything. So that's why this is a word, everything. Okay. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much for your feedback. So again, I will repeat my questions. What does belong to culture? And then I think almost 80 to 90% of the students answered the question without A, B, C, D, E, and F, or almost all of those options are culture. Yeah, that's a great answer, spot on, you guys. So give applause for you guys. Thank you so much for your answer, for your feedback. Then I still have one question. This is the definition of the culture from one of the figures. We call it with the Linton. So please, there is a three words that is still a blank letter. So please, can you fill in the letter who didn't on that point? Okay, life ideas habits. You answer quickly. Life ideas habits. Okay, that's the students of SMA Pradita Digantara. They are so smart, so they can answer the question. Even I only mentioned. I just show my question, then they already answer quickly. Yeah, thank you, Firendi, and all of the students of SMA Pradita Digantara. So that's correct. So culture defines as a way of life of its members, the collection of the ideas and the habits which they learn, share, transmit from generation to generation. That's the definition of culture based on Linton. So memang benar kalau misalnya sebuah kebudayaan itu didefinisikan sebagai suatu jalan hidup dari suatu anggota tertentu yang berisikan tentang ide-ide dan juga atau gagasan dan juga kebiasaan-kebiasaan yang mereka pelajari, kemudian mereka bagikan dan juga tularkan dari generasi ke generasi. Tadi kan banyak sekali bahasa Indonesia. We know that we have a lot of oceans in Indonesia. That's why we have many languages as well. That's a part of our culture. This is the definition of the Linton. Kalau menurut Kunchoro Ningrat, tahun 2002, itu budaya itu merupakan keseluruhan sistem gagasan, tadi juga disebutkan ideas, kemudian tindakan itu bisa menuju ke habit, dan hasil karya manusia. Language itu kan juga termasuk salah satu hasil karya dari manusia dalam rangka kehidupan masyarakat yang dijadikan milik diri manusia dengan belajar, which they learn, share, and transmit from generation to generation. That's the definition of the culture. And then we back to the definition of what is cross-cultural understanding. Kalau misalnya kita, kita potong satu arti dari satu persatu dari kata, itu ada tiga istilah. Cross-cultural sama understanding. Cross itu mungkin kita kalau bahasa kasarnya itu silang gitu kan. Terus kalau misalnya cultural itu tadi bisa bagi dari kebudayaan. Understanding itu pemahaman. Itu kalau dari bahasanya. Tapi kalau dari definisi yang sederhananya itu seperti ini. Jadi cross-cultural understanding itu means to value other cultures and respect their views. Jadi diharapkan ketika nanti, ini nggak cuma hanya di international organization or international community. You know that when you are going to the SMA Pradita Digantara, we have many people comes from the west to the east and then from the south to the north. We are having a different values. We are having a different maybe language or characteristics. That's why we need to learn about cross-cultural understanding so we can respect and value what they have and what they already have in the on their own, seperti itu. Jadi kalau karena jadi murid dari SMA Pradita Dirgantara itu tidak hanya dari Solo saja, tapi berasal dari seluruh Indonesia. Mereka kan punya bahasa yang berbeda mungkin, terus juga karakter yang berbeda, budaya yang berbeda. Nah, diharapkan ketika anak-anakku semuanya ini belajar tentang cross-cultural understanding, anak-anakku semua itu tidak akan istilahnya apa ya, melakukan rasis atau judgment terhadap teman-temannya ketika sudah berada di SMA Pradita Dirgantara, atau ketika teman-teman atau anak-anakku semuanya itu memiliki beda pendapat dengan orang lain, seperti itu. Itu salah satu tujuan dari cross-cultural understanding. Nah, why is CCU so important? Jadi kenapa CCU itu sangat penting? Itu ada gambar pesawat yang sedang mengitari bumi. Ada gambar dua orang. Mereka gak pacaran, mereka berteman. Tapi mereka jalan-jalan keliling dunia. Terus the third picture is some sports tourism area in the world. Jadi kenapa belajar CCU itu penting? So, we are expecting when you are graduating from the SMA Pradita Dirgantara, nanti anak-anak semua itu, maybe ada salah satu anak-anak yang will continue study abroad. Atau mungkin mau ikut short course atau long course gitu. Jadi ketika anak-anakku semuanya itu belajar ke luar negeri atau melakukan perjalanan ke luar negeri, you won't have a shock culture. Jadi tidak akan mengalami yang namanya culture shock. Jadi anak-anak kan bisa beradaptasi dengan baik karena anak-anak sudah memiliki basic, yaitu cross-cultural understanding. Ini juga sangat penting karena sekarang kita memasuki yang namanya globalization era. We are member of the MEA, Masyarakat Ekonomi ASEAN. Jadi itu sangat penting juga untuk pergaulan kita di international community. Termasuk webinar-webinar kan juga banyak sekali yang dilakukan secara global atau internasional. Then, What is CCU program at SMA Pradita Dirgantara? Apa aja sih program-programnya yang ada di SMA Pradita Dirgantara? Salah satunya yaitu webinar. Apa itu webinar? Jadi mungkin nanti kita akan mengundang, dan planningnya kita akan bekerja sama dengan Universitas 11 Maret karena kita menjadi lab school-nya Universitas 11 Maret. Dan di Universitas 11 Maret itu ada salah satu unit yang namanya International Office. And then we will invite one of the students from the other countries to come to our school to share the culture with them di SMA Pradita Dirgantara tentunya. Jadi bisa melalui karena masih masa pandemik, we can do using the radio of SMA Pradita Dirgantara. Nanti kita mengadakan kayak semacam podcast or broadcast, so we can do interaction with the foreigner. And then juga mungkin nanti di bulan Februari yang seperti kami sampaikan kemarin ada live-in or sit-in. Ini yang baju merah sama putih itu maksudnya live-in atau sit-in. Seperti itu. Kemudian kita juga bisa visiting tourism area yang ada di Solo dan sekitarnya. Jadi kita bisa mengundang some foreigners to join with us. And then we will conduct a journey with them. Kita bisa visiting some spot area, tourism area di Solo dan sekitarnya. And then nanti anak-anakku semuanya berperan sebagai turis misalnya di situ. Itu nanti kita sudah berperan atau belajar tentang cross-cultural understanding. Atau nanti kita bisa ke jalan-jalan ke misalnya dusun wisata misalnya, atau menginap, sleep over for one night, two days, or three days or three nights or four nights with the foreigner. Kita bareng-bareng misalnya membuat suatu program social community, and then kita membuat suatu project dengan yang tadi foreigner tadi, kemudian kita misalnya ikut dalam keseharian masyarakat misalnya di sekitar Gunung Merapi atau di sekitar Gunung Lawu. Itu beberapa program dari CCU at SMA Pradita Dirgantara. Jadi setelah tadi you are studying about language courses, and then at the CCU program, di sini kalian itu mengimplementasikan what you have got from the language courses. Jadi bahasa itu kalian akan menjadi bisa kalau terbiasa. digunakan untuk berkomunikasi. Itu salah satu tujuan penting dari CCU program. And then sekarang ini saya minta it's time to share ya, learn from everyone. Tadi kayaknya sudah ada anak yang mau sharing. Ada beberapa anak ternyata di SMA Pradita Dirgantara yang sudah stay or maybe doing a journey in the other countries, so they will share their experiences with us. So silakan, tadi kayaknya ada Muhammad Rafif kalau nggak salah ya. Please showing the chat. Tadi kayaknya sudah ada yang mau ikut sharing tentang pengalaman. Atau siapapun boleh, silakan. Siapapun boleh yang pernah pergi ke luar negeri atau pernah tinggal di luar negeri atau sudah pernah join. Kira-kira pengalaman apa yang kalian dapatkan? Yang pertama kali kalian kesana itu kalian mengalami culture shock atau kalian sudah belajar tentang cultural understanding. Anything you can share with us here. So we learn from everyone. Please. Who wants to share? Tadi kayaknya Rafiq sudah ini deh. Silakan yang mau sharing. Halo. Halo, coba sudah ada belum Pak Andri? Coba, silakan anakku yang kemarin kayaknya ada yang fluent, very fluent speaking English, or speak English fluently. Siapa ya kalau nggak salah namanya Clara or someone?
Farah sama Farel, silakan sudah aktif mikrofon.
Oh iya, Farah sama Farel.
Yep.
Please show your face and then unmute your microphone to share the knowledge with you here. Layarnya, silakan.
Yang Pak.
Hello, Farel. Good afternoon, Farel. How are you?
Fine.
Hello, Farel.
Ya Pak.
Okay, can you share with us your experience? What do you have? What did you do?
Oke Pak, ini perjalanannya sih sudah agak lumayan cukup lama sih Pak menurut saya. Pak.
Can you please speak in English, Farel?
Okay, I'll try my best.
Yeah, thank you. Please tell us your experience.
So I think back in 2018, if I'm not mistaken.
2018, yes. Where did you go?
My school has a program, a global program, and at 2018 they offered the students to go to the United Kingdom.
Oh, you were going to the UK, huh? Then.
And so we are going to stay there for around 2 weeks.
2 weeks, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so I'm not really sure about, I don't really talk about their culture. They don't really ask about my culture, but I think from my perspective is the people from the UK is very open to other culture. They try to ask a lot about our culture, but in my case, because I don't really know what my culture is back then, because I'm not really interested in my own culture, so I couldn't share it to the people in UK, my friends at the United Kingdom, that we were made to be as friends for the school period.
Then, did you feel the culture shock when you were in UK for the very first time?
A little bit, because it wasn't really a common experience to meet other people from other countries, especially when you talk in their language,
mm-hmm.
you don't really know how to talk to them, to start a conversation. It's really sometimes very complicated. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the people from UK, they really like to learn about other cultures. That's what I'm trying to say.
They like about what?
They like to talk about other people's culture. They like to talk about our origins. What do we do?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
what do we do at our country, what do we do in our daily life. Back in my, so I stay with a, I'm gonna say an elderly, either it's a middle-aged or an elderly woman for my stay for 2 weeks. And it's very different from their culture. The people, how do they say it? Can I speak a little bit Indonesian, Mr. Joko?
Yeah, sure. Or you can explain in bahasa also, okay. Yeah.
Okay, jadi ternyata kultur mereka itu dari mulai dari orang tuanya itu sudah berbeda sekali Pak Joko dengan orang-orang tua yang ada di negara ini, menurut saya, Pak Joko. Mm-hmm. Jadi di sana itu TV saja Pak Joko, yang nonton TV yang biasanya kita di Indonesia kita bisa nonton setiap hari atau setiap malam dari pagi atau sampai malam. Mm-hmm. Jadi di sana pas saya tinggal di rumah mereka itu tidak digunakan TV-nya Pak Joko.
Oh, gitu. Hah. Itu jadi, habitnya gitu ya.
Mm-hmm. Habitnya itu saya bilang berbeda sekali dari negara kita. Lalu karena UK ini negara itu multikultural, banyak sekali pendatang dari luar dan juga mereka tidak terbentuk dari orang-orang asli UK-nya juga. Mm-hmm. Mereka banyak sekali culture seperti bagaimana ya cara bilangnya? Bisa bilang kita seperti ketika kita melihat ketika keadaan di sekolahnya itu juga cukup berbeda Pak Joko untuk belajar itu juga berbeda.
Okay. Itu tadi ya experience dari Muhammad Farel Rafif. Terima kasih untuk sharingnya. Thank you. And maybe one more students ya. Tadi kayaknya ada one little girls yang mau tell us. Thank you Farel for your sharing.
Sama-sama Joko.
Great job. Mm-hmm. Dan tadi ada siapa lagi Pak Andri, cewek yang mau sharing?
Excuse me?
Yes. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Patu Puchi Dewi from class 10A.
Mm-hmm. How do I call you? Ratu or Dewi? Ratu. Okay, then?
And when I was in year 2, my parents and I moved to Australia for 5 years. Wow. And I went to primary school there. And when I first arrived there, I was really shocked by how clean it was, first of all. And also, I couldn't speak English at all when I first came there, so all I did was smile at everyone because I couldn't understand any of them.
That's great. Yeah.
From my experience, I think that people in Australia or in Perth specifically, where I was in, they're very open. Like I've mentioned before, they're very open about other people's culture. Mm-hmm. And because I couldn't speak English very well, they helped me out a lot. So they tried to understand what I was trying to say. Mm-hmm. And they didn't judge me for not being able to speak English.
Then?
Also, for the educational program that they have, it's very sports oriented. And my school held inter-school sports competitions every year. Mm-hmm. And also their education is very, like we did a lot of excursions and hands-on stuff. We experimented a lot and stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think I didn't really have a cultural shock when I went there because I was very young. Mm-hmm. But I more had a cultural shock when I came back to Indonesia because I pretty much forgot Indonesian.
So you speak English as well when you were in Australia with your parents?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then how did you adapt with the culture that because you were still small, right? Were you crying or for the very first time join with a school in Australia?
Yes. So My parents told me that I could speak, I would be able to speak English within 2 months. And when 2 months passed, I still couldn't really speak English. So I cried.
That's okay. That?
So yeah, I think.
Tell us about when you come back again to Indonesia. You said that you have a culture shock from Australia and then to Indonesia. What kind of culture shocks did you have at that time?
So I came back when it was the year for UN. So I only had one semester to study for UN.
UDN Nasional. Oh my God. So you were back to Indonesia when you are in the grade 9. Is it?
Six.
Yeah. Then?
I was shocked because in Indonesia, we are expected to study by memorizing in my SP.
Yeah.
We had to memorize a lot of things, whereas in Australia, we were expected to understand them, not like memorize them. And also, like I said, I couldn't really speak Indonesian very well.
That's okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then, how did your result? How's your result for the national exam results? Because you only studied 1 year, yeah. How's the result?
It was pretty good.
It was pretty good. Okay. Then, anything else that you want to tell to us?
Well, in Australia, everyone's just really open and accepting of other people's culture. And I think in Indonesia, we're starting to become like that as well. So that's good.
Okay, that's it? Okay, thank you, Ratu Dewi. Ratu Dewi, we give applause. Very good English, ya. Saya aja kalah kayak minder, saya minder. Okay, Bapak Ibu, that's all my explanation about cross-cultural understanding. And I'm waiting for all of the students to join the cross-cultural understanding. The CCU program is a must for every grades from the grade 10 to 12, yeah? Noted that it is a must for grade 10 to 12. That's all. Thank you. And see you next time. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bapak Ibu, Ibu Erni, ada question and answer pro? Ada. Besok. Oh, oke. Okay. Buat anak-anakku semuanya, terima kasih untuk partisipasinya hari ini di Pradita Digantara Weeks of Welcome Day 4. We still have technical things for critical essay and PPS will be delivered tomorrow. So, terima kasih semuanya. Selamat beristirahat dan juga selamat menunaikan ibadah sholat. Sampai jumpa kembali besok. Tetap jaga kesehatan. Selamat siang. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Pak. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.